Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make this short animation. This tutorial will be divided into several parts, and that is modeling, texturing, rigging, animation, environment and lighting, finally, final compositing in After Effects. A little reminder, in this video, I'll be just covering the breakdown of the process, not the whole step-by-step in details. So, without further ado, let's jump right into it. First part, modeling. Before I even begin the modeling process, I started with gathering some reference of Optimus Prime. Here, as you can see, I made some blueprint from Optimus Prime toy review video. Here's the quick time lapse of the modeling process. First, I import the blueprint to Blender to use it as a reference. And then I create a cube, adjust it to fit the blueprint, and then go into edit mode, press Ctrl R to make a loop cut in the middle of the cube, delete the left side of the cube, and then you can add mirror modifier, so that if you make one adjustment to the one side, it will be mirrored perfectly to the other side. Basically like that, and then you can adjust it to fit the blueprint. Make sure to check it from the front view, side view, and back view. After one shape is done, move on to other shape. Just like that, you can add some detail by pressing I to create an inset, or E to create an extrude. After blocking every part of the 3D model, here you can see my quick test render of Optimus Prime. To add some details into the 3D model, you can add bevel modifier. Here I'm using 0.04 amount in one segment. Make sure to check the harder normals menu and auto smooth on normal section. Here you can see the difference between using and not using the bevel modifier. It adds some smooth curve around the edge. For the texturing part, I'm basically using this node setup. Here I'm mixing two principled BSDF. One with the bright red color, and the second is with the darker red color. And I want the darker red color to appear on the edge of the 3D model. You can actually change the color. Here, as you can see, I'm changing to silver. So it appears on the edge like a rusty effect. But in this 3D model, I want to make it a darker color. For the maxing, the value is determined by this node group. So I'm using bevel node and geometry node from normal socket, put it into the vector mat node set into dot product, and then invert the value, and then goes for the color output. After that, you can set the value with the map range if you want to be higher or lower value. Basically, it's like that for the red color, the blue color, even the silver part on the hip and on the leg. It's basically the same note. For the rigging part, I'm using a quite simple rig. Here, as you can see, make sure you parent this hand bone into the body bone. The neck bone is also parent into the body bone. The leg bone is parent into the hip bone. And then the hip bone is parent into the body bone. So if I were to move the body bone, the whole part of the body will follow as well. And for this part of the bone, it's actually the truck part that will come out later in the transformation process. And this part of the body, this side part of the body, will come hidden in the main body. This part and this part as well, make sure the bone is parent into the body bone. And for the tire, I'm actually using copy rotation constraint, so the tire will follow the rotation of this object. This is so that I can animate the tire individually from the body animation. Just like that. And each part of this body is parent into the bone. This part of the body is parent into this bone. And this part is parent into this bone. Like so. Like that. For the animation part, I'm using the sound from the original cartoon to help me guide through the animation. Here's what it sounds like. So, from this sound, I hear that the movement is divided into 5 segments. So, in each segment, I'm adding a marker to know when the timing is. You can do it by simply click marker, add marker in this first part, second part, third part, fourth part, and last, fifth part. So, in the first part, the hand starts to come out to the side. And this front part of the truck starts to go up inside the chest part. For the chest part, start to extrude out to the front. For the extrusion, I'm using a shape key. Here, I have one for the original shape and the second one for the extruded one. If I change the value, it will get extruded like so. Then I can animate it. And the tire comes in. And to make the shape change like this, I'm actually using a boolean in this shape. Here's the boolean. With the operation difference, and the object is this cube. So when the animation come, the cube will go to the side. And that's basically for the first part. For the second part, the hand rotates to the front, like so. And this blue hands comes out from inside. And the head comes out as well, like so. And when the front truck part comes in, the side body part comes out, like so. And as you can see, the leg comes up as well. And I also change the color of the hip part. So in the truck mode, it's colored red. And into robot mode, it's colored silver. The hip and the thighs. Like so. Also, the bumper changing as well because of shape key, like this, the front part as well. And next to the third part, the body continue to get up. The leg goes to the front, like so. The truck part comes fully inside the chest part, and this side body comes out. And for the fourth part, the hand starts to come down, and it nearly gets to the standing up point, like so. And for the last part, it gets stand up, Optimus Prime stand up, and the hand part goes to the front, from the back to the front, like so. So if we start from the beginning, let me just hide the bone first so you can see it clearly. First part, second part, third part, fourth part, and the last part, like so. Okay, for the environment part, I'm using this dome. This dome is textured from projected HDRI, and you can actually change the HDRI, like so. So I'll explain to you the node setup. Basically, I'm using mix shader to mix the image texture node with the HDR texture on it, with the diffuse shader, with the color set from the HDR as well, like this. As for the mixing, is determined by this node. This is the vector mat node set to length, with the input vector from the texture coordinate object, and then you can change the value with mat range node. Let me show you the mixing node looks like. Basically, looks like this. So the white part will be the diffuse part, where there will be shadow on the ground, and the black part will be the sky part. As for the lighting part, I'm using the same HDRI like in the dome, and set it in the world tab. Make sure you have the same light direction between the HDRI in the dome and in the world tab, and then you can try to render it out. But from my experience, when I rendered it out, I ran into some problem. Let me show you. So the first time I rendered it out, it got tons of fireflies all over the place. Even when I'm using the noise menu, it got this weird artifact too. So the solution that I got is to separate the dome into two parts. The first part is the sky part, and the second part is the ground part. And then you can separate it into two different collections. Here's for the sky part, and here's the collection for the ground part. And then for the first render, you want to disable the sky in the viewport and disable it in renders as well. And you want to render only the 3D model and the ground part. Make sure you go to the render properties under the film section and check this transparent menu. So you can render it with transparent background and save it as PNG sequence. Here I'm using 200 sample with the noise menu checked on. As for the second render, you can render only the sky part with the same setting with transparent background. And then you can join both renders in Compositor. In the Compositor, here's I'm using After Effects. You can import both renders and then join it. Here's, as you can see, I'm joining both the 3D model and the ground with the sky render. And you can see as well in the ground and in the sky, there's little to no artifact like before. And then I precomp these two render into one composition, and then I can add some effect like this dust wave that comes out when Optimus Prime gets up. Here's I'm using the screen blending mode is the normal, and here's the screen blending mode to make the black part of the footage disappear. And then I'm adding some sound effect like the transforming part, the background music, and the engine sound. And then finally, you can render the final result. Okay guys, that's all for the breakdown process of Optimus Prime G1 transformation animation. If you have any input and suggestion, please type it in on the comment section down below. And don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button if you find this video useful. And you can check me out as well on my Instagram account on rengi.art if you want to see more of my artwork. Thanks for watching and see ya!